don't speak Spanish. In English, please.
Look in my eyes, what do you see? The cult of personality. The cult of personality.
Good Friday afternoon. Welcome to the Voice of Ocala. I'm Tom Schmitz, coming to you live from the palatial studios of WOCA Radio, just outside the food court entrance to the Paddock Mall in the Brick City Beautiful, Ocala, Florida, and a sunny Ocala, Florida, but wait 5 minutes, that'll change. I'm joined, it is Ask the Cops, as it is every Friday. This Friday, I'm joined by Captain Corey Taylor of the Ocala Police Department. Captain Taylor, good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon.
You got to lean a little bit closer in there.
All right.
Yeah.
There we go.
Captain Taylor, now, you, how long have you been with the Ocala Police Department?
On September 5th, I will celebrate my 16th year with the Ocala Police Department.
Now, did you start as a patrol officer with the Ocala Police Department?
I did.
Captain in 16 years, that's moving it.
God is good, I guess.
So, I ask everyone this that comes in that has been has made a career out of the Ocala Police Department. I know the answer is yes, a lot, so I want to see your take on it. The city has changed dramatically in the 16 years since you first hired on as a patrol officer. But what are some of the biggest changes that stick out in your mind to the city since you became a patrol officer 16 years ago?
Well, I guess I would say, first and foremost, I think my perspective might be a little different than most because I have the pleasure of being born and raised here. So, I mean, I've
so Ocala's changed a lot.
Ocala's.
You're like 33, 34, so Ocala's changed a lot.
Yeah, you're my best friend. I'm a little bit older, but it has. And honestly, just I think the biggest change is obviously the size, you know, and obviously as growth happens, you know, then the types of calls change as far as what I've seen over the course of my 16-year career. The types of calls change, the people you encounter change, but for the most part, it's easy for us because, you know, our mission every day is to protect, you know, life and property. So regardless of the changes in size of the city, the types of calls or the quantity of calls that come in, our objective is the same every day, so it's easy to kind of handle that.
You remember 200 and it was two lanes.
I do. I do.
Yes. You don't go back long enough to remember when it was dirt, but you remember when it was two lanes.
I do. I do, very much so.
Now, did you grow up, born and raised here in Marion County or in the city of Ocala?
In the city of Ocala.
You grew up on the east side, the west side?
I was 1900 block of Southwest 4th Street.
Southwest 4th Street.
Yes, I was born at Monroe, and then, like I said, raised in the West District of Ocala.
I tell you what, people can say what they want about all the grocery stores and all around here. Mm-hmm. Some of the best meat and seafood you'll ever get is on the west side of this city right there.
On
40.
I agree with you.
Some of the meat and seafood shops, tell you what.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I mean, like I said, I honestly, you know, as much as people try to, you know, or, you know, identify them or differentiate them, we're all the same. I mean, it's the same on both sides of the town, just to, you know.
I saw a lady, and in this time that we're in right now, Buddy Martin, who is on the show all the time, he says he grew up in the 40s and 50s and 60s in this town.
Mm-hmm.
He remembers pre civil rights era in Ocala. He thinks it's worse. And he remembers not in Ocala, but mm-hmm. he remembers the pre civil rights era. He thinks race relations in our country right now are as bad, if not worse, than they were at that time.
That's I honestly think it's all about perspective. I mean, it's about your experiences and the things that you've seen. I can see both sides of the coin, but I think as long as we continue to to communicate. That's the biggest thing. Anytime I'm dealing with something that's unfamiliar to me or, you know, uncharted territory, I try to associate it with something that is familiar to me, you know. And so for me, a lot of the problems that I encounter at work or situations I'm dealing with, I usually look at them, you know, from the standpoint of family, because I know that I come from a big family that where public service is kind of interwoven, you know, throughout my family. And the biggest thing for me, I've learned that if we can start connecting with each other, once you connect, then ultimately there's going to be some type of communication, because very rarely are you going to sit in a, you know, in a specific location, you know, with another group of people and nobody says anything. So by connecting, you begin to communicate, and then through that communication, then you begin to kind of understand the people, you know, in the room besides yourself. And with that understanding, then, you know, ultimately there's going to be some respect. And that's what we need, you know, to ultimately facilitate the trust that we need to kind of do the community policing objective. So, you know, race relations, I think at the end of the day, if we just look at it from the standpoint that we need to continue reaching out to each other, continue to communicate and talk so that we can learn, you know, the differences or the different perspectives and then kind of understand them, I think we'll be, you know, I know we'll be okay.
See, now I think you hit on a very, very important word that I don't think a lot of people really in this divisive time of the talking heads on both sides of the mm-hmm. issue that want to bang their chest and scream and holler, and that gets the face of what's going on, but that's not really the day-to-day going on. And no. I'll tell you how I know this. I live in West Ocala. Mm-hmm. I live over by John Deere and in that area and in the northwest part mm-hmm. of Ocala. So I go into a lot of the convenience stores and Family Dollar type places and all on the way to and from work that are in a predominantly African American area of our city. Mm-hmm. And what I do is what my mother taught me to do, what my grandmother taught me to do, what I'm sure your mother and mm-hmm. grandmother, if somebody is coming out the door and it's a female, you open the door, step aside and say, here you go, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
It doesn't matter whether you're black, purple, green, white. And when you do that and you show respect to each other, I find that people say, I've had friends that go, so you kind of looking over your shoulder now when you go into those stores? I said, no. Mm-hmm. Those people, the people in those stores, the white people, the black people, the purple people, mm-hmm. if I show respect to my fellow man or woman, they will return that respect back. And if they 100%. Don't, that's on them, that's not on me.
Exactly.
And that's what I think we miss that it's not a skin color issue.
No.
It's a respect issue. And
agreed.
If you show respect, you'll get respect in return.
That is absolutely correct.
I heard a lady talk the other day. She said that to say that we have problems with race is incorrect, because race is something that man dreamed up to show that that one person is better than another person.
Exactly.
There's only one race on the face of the earth. The human race.
The human race. That's it.
I thought
she hit the nail on the head.
She hit the nail right on the head.
She did.
But that we, as we're talking, and you and I could sit here and have a good conversation, we do know there are dangers that lie out there around every corner. Because I don't want to say that people aren't as intelligent as you and I are, but there are some people who refuse to see the intelligence of communication, who want to stir the pot. And when we come back, I want to talk to you about you being a man of color in the job you're in. I want to see if you feel like that makes your job more or less dangerous than any other, than an officer not of color.
Okay.
I'll ask you that question next right here on Ask the Cops, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz.
Hi, I'm State Farm agent Angie Lewis. Come see me and my team for all your insurance and financial needs in the beautiful downtown historic district, 416 East Fort King Street, or call 291-2444.
Commercial bank approval. Vehicle purchase price fixed rate alone.
Is your old car dead? Then declare your independence and say yes to red, white, and you in a nicer, newer car.
Chris Spears from Prestige Auto Sales, your dealer for the people. This month, we want to help you get approved.
Even if you've heard no in the past, we believe you deserve to drive a nicer, newer car today.
Past credit problems are welcome here. We look at the story behind the score to help you drive a nicer, newer car today. So pop into action and zoom into a nicer, newer car faster than you ever thought possible.
Worried about firecrackers on your credit report? My For the People credit approval process is the bomb. We work with the banks and lenders who want you to declare your independence.
Plus, right now, you could save up to $4,000 depending on the car you choose. But hurry, this deal's done once we've helped 77 people blast off in a nicer, newer car. I'm Chris Spears, a dealer for the people.
Visit Prestige on Highway 200 in Ocala, online at prestigefree.com, or call 694-1234. Yes, 694-1234. See you at Prestige.
This is Kendall Carpenter with Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club. I wanted to introduce you to the finest equestrian opportunity available. If you love horses and enjoy Central Florida's mild climate and rich rolling landscape, come explore Golden Ocala. Bridle trails weave their way through this stunningly beautiful community of stately homes. Our state-of-the-art equestrian center will meet all of your equestrian needs with style. Visit us at goldenocala.com.
Gene Powell Pasture Mowing. Our tractor services include bush hog, disking, front end loader, box blade, and stump grinding. We also have zero turn mowers for the smaller paddocks, IOAs, fence rows, and lawn care. Fence row spraying is also available for weed control. We are licensed and insured. Gene Powell Pasture Mowing, 352-629-2440, or online at PowellGene, G-E-N-E, at yahoo.com. Gene Powell Pasture Mowing.
Hi, I'm Seth with AA Lock, Dock, and Security. Have you ever thought about the locks or security on your house or business? Have you ever wondered why the keys to your new car cost so much? Well, at AA Lock, Dock, and Security, we can help with securing your valuables. We can even replace those expensive transponder keys. We can give you the knowledge that no one else will. Call AA Lock, Dock, and Security at 867-1965. That's 867-1965.
Yeah, I'm that drip coming down from the corner of the room. But where did I come from? I'll never tell.
Bone Dry Roofing can, and we'll fix it right the first time using quality materials, and we'll deal honestly and fairly with you, period. You can find Bone Dry Roofing on their website, BoneDryRoofingLLC.com, and Facebook at Bone Dry Roofing LLC. Do it right before your roof needs a tarp to keep the elements out. Bone Dry Roofing stands behind their work to help make your home safe and secure. Plus, they have financing available. Remember, if you're not bone dry, then you're all wet.
Putting the local back into radio. 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. WOCA News. Variety. Information. Now. Keep your arms and legs on the inside at all times.
This is James Snyder inviting you to join me each Sunday morning at 9:30 for Sunday Joy on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM.
We are The Source, WOCA.
Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala, Ask the Cops. As we always say, some of the best conversations happen off the air. Some of the best conversations happen off the air. Captain Corey Taylor is in studio with us. Now, Captain Taylor, what is your actual assignment at the police department?
Currently, I've been afforded the opportunity to work all throughout the department. I've had the luxury of actually carrying out or working in nearly every assignment that we've had, which I think ultimately has made me, you know, a lot more well-rounded. But currently, I'm assigned in the East District of Ocala. The city is broken up into two districts, East and West, which is defined or divided by Pine Avenue or 441, 301. And so I'm currently the district commander for the East District of Ocala.
You're the district commander for the golf course.
Yes, sir. That's my area.
See, that's how I look at it. That's how somebody said, but there's a golf course on the west side too. But that's Pine Oaks. That's because there's the golf course and there's Pine Oaks. I know both of them well.
I know both of them well too.
You're also the district commander for one of my favorite. How should I say this? Adult watering holes.
And which one would that be?
The one across from the golf course.
Okay.
Let's just say it has a little Scottish flavor.
Gotcha. I gotcha. I'm with you.
So, now how long have you been the commander on the east side?
I took over that assignment in October of last year.
Now, you've been a captain for how long now?
October of last year. Yes.
So before we get to the what we were talking about earlier, race relations, I want to talk to you about Greg Graham.
Okay.
Because, you know, he comes across as even-keeled, laid-back, just good at communications. Mm-hmm. Just, come on, that can't be for real.
Oh, no, my chief is smooth. He's smooth, so and I think that's a benefit to the department because there's an old canine saying I was never a canine handler. I had secret desires, but I was never one. But they one of the things they say is that the attitude runs down leash. So if you have a high strung handler, usually had a high strung dog. So but I look at that in the standpoint of leadership, and essentially because he is, you know, even keel and he's laid back and he's, you know, he makes good decisions, that attitude ultimately will, you know, kind of transcend down the chain of command and extend to our police officers that are on the street. So he's a benefit to us, you know, in that, you know, that we have, you know, that type of leader to be able to follow. So
now you worked for him for a while when he was here before he went and took the chief job in Iowa.
That is correct.
And was he that laid back then too?
He was. I think he was. Yeah, he was my deputy chief for a little while. When I joined the police department, I believe he was a major over investigations, and then he became the deputy chief before he left for his stint in Iowa.
What's wrong with the man jumping out of planes, though? You know what I mean? Come on. Why jump out of a perfectly good aircraft?
That's interesting. I don't know. You'd have to ask him that one, but yeah, maybe this job is not dangerous enough.
So. I ask him that all the time, and he says, it's great. Come with me. No, I'm not doing it.
Yeah, I don't know either. I have a bucket list, but I don't know that that's on it.
Now, and you, the saying you said, at the end of the leash, it flows down the leash, and that goes for the majors, the captains, the lieutenants, all the way down to, it seems to me that in my lifetime, I have a lot of friends that are deputy sheriffs and police in Statesboro, Georgia, and Bullitt County, Georgia. I know a lot of those guys. And it seems that some of those guys were on the edge and other ones weren't. But I talked to a lot of the police officers in this. It seems like I've not yet met someone that is on the edge all the time in this police department. Yet, this police department does a very good job with investigating and keeping crime as minimal as you can keep it in a city this size. That comes straight down through the chief and all the brass below him.
Absolutely. I mean, I tell the guys that work with me, and I never say anybody works for me, but with me. But I often tell them that the job of the chief is to outline the vision. You know, it's his job to tell us where we're going. You know, and then from there, the responsibility flows downhill for us to kind of plot the course. You know, but and although I may have a different supervisory style or have different teachings, at the end of the day, when I'm plotting the course for the people that are working with me in my district, those directions have to be in line, you know, with the vision that the chief has set out. So, but absolutely, it has to flow down.
And I'll take a prime example of how calm, cool, and collective you and your men and women are that work for you or work with you. Mm-hmm. Yesterday had to be a trying afternoon about 5 o'clock in the afternoon.
Yes.
It had to be a difficult situation because there were storms coming through. Looked like it was either a microburst or a small tornado that came through Fort King, 25th, on down through the neighborhood back there on out to Maricamp. And within minutes of that storm coming through with lights down and live wires with fire and everything, the men and women of the Ocala Police Department had roads blocked. Traffic was still moving good. What takes place in the minutes after you get that call as a commander of that area, because that was right near. Were you on yesterday when that
I
happened?
I was. Yes.
What happens when you get that? That's your area. You're the commander of that area. What takes place in the 2 or 3, 4 minutes, 5 minutes once that call comes in that, for lack of a better term, all Hades broke loose?
Yeah. Well, I mean, when you consider what our overall mission is, it's to protect life and property in that order, and so. In the first few minutes, essentially, we're basically trying to make sure that life is protected. That means that all the traffic, you know, all the traffic intersections that aren't manned, you know, that where lights are down, we need to make sure that people are in place so that we can facilitate the safe movement of people in traffic, you know, vehicle and pedestrian traffic, in instances where residences, you know, have been damaged or, you know, by fallen, you know, branches. But basically, I mean, when we're putting things in or prioritizing our list, first and foremost, we're trying to make sure that the public is safe. And then once we've done that, then we can kind of take a breath and now begin, you know, the restoration process as far as, okay, let's get Public Works, let's get them on this scene, let's begin to kind of look at the different situations and see which ones need to be addressed first, and move on from there. But it makes it easy because we know what our ultimate goal is, first life. And so, you know, we take those actions that are necessary to preserve that, and then we move on to, you know, protecting property and addressing that.
Let's talk for a minute about the preparation for something like that. Because that storm, you know, we all were used to afternoon storms, mm-hmm. but nobody knew, or the general public, I don't think, knew that the storm was going to be that severe.
Right.
Did you guys have a kind of a heads up that it may get a little squirrely yesterday afternoon?
I think you hit the nail on the head. I don't know that we had the information that particular storm was coming or would be, you know, of that magnitude to cause some of the situations that it did. But you were touching on a word that really defines who we are, and that's preparation. And you know, we have, you know, different scenarios, and we try to train to make sure that our people are mission ready, so that, you know, in the event of something catastrophic that we can't necessarily prepare for, you know, that we're already ready, because a lot of times you may not have time, you know, to get things, you know, to plan. So in the absence of an opportunity to plan for something, if you're prepared, you know, then all you have to do is now take action and move forward.
So as long as you're very well prepared, you can move forward on the actions that need to be taken.
Absolutely, yeah. And believe it or not, we have plans, you know, for every scenario that somebody could, you know, fathom. You know, we have a response plan for it. Like I said, sometimes you get lucky, and or not necessarily lucky, but sometimes those particular things happen, and now you have your checks and balance, your list that you can go down, and sometimes something you haven't prepared for, but, you know, because of the men and women that we have, you know, in place, we're able to address it fairly quickly.
When you talk about something you're not prepared for, we're going to discuss later in the show, how do you prepare for the unexpected? Mm-hmm. And nothing more unexpected than what took place last evening in France, Nice, France. Yes. And I know you try to plan for everything. I know you guys do. I've seen you do exercises here at the mall where you plan for different situations.
Absolutely.
Without going into what you do, you
right.
just plan for different situations and everything. It's just hard to imagine anybody would ever plan for a truck barreling through thousands of people gathering around watching fireworks. It's just difficult to believe. But we'll talk with Captain Corey Taylor a little after the break. We also will take your phone calls after the break. I know that some of you want to get in and ask the captain a few questions. We'll take your phone calls after the break. Coming up in hour number two today, we're going to talk about the tragedy that was Nice, France yesterday. And it's just, I've said it numerous times on this show, it's getting far too common and far too non-surprising. It, you know, when people said, hey, you know, what surprised me yesterday in France was how many people that the weapon used, not that people were killed in a terrorist attack. And that's not a good thing. Coming up after the break, we'll talk with Chris Spears of Prestige Auto. At 5 o'clock, it's Southern Pigskin tonight. It's our SEC Media Days wrap-up show. Buddy Martin was at SEC Media Days earlier this week. He talked with Tony Barnhart, Mr. College Football. We also had some conversations with Coach Jim McElwain. We heard from Coach Kirby Smart of the Georgia Bulldogs. All that yet to come on today in Southern Pigskin tonight. That's at 5 o'clock for all of those that are tuned in. But coming up next, more with Captain Corey Taylor of the Ocala Police Department. You're listening to the Voice of Ocala. Remember, no, Buddy Martin not in today. I am Tom Schmitz filling in for Buddy. Buddy will be back in on Monday. Coming up next, more with Captain Corey Taylor, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Who doesn't love heading out on the boat with a family, hitting the ATV trails with friends, or blazing new stretches of highway with riding buddies? Your toys are your ticket to outdoor fun. At the McDonald Allstate Agency, we get to know you and help make sure you have all the right coverages. Plus, when you bundle your coverage for your car and your home with your boat, motorcycle, RV, or more, you can save up to 30%. So call the McDonald Allstate Agency today at 622-2333 or stop by one of our two Ocala locations at Cala Hills or the Jasmine Square Plaza.
Subject to terms, conditions, and availability. Savings vary.
Have you been diagnosed with BPH or an enlarged prostate gland? Are you tired of getting up at night to visit the bathroom? You may be eligible for the Equinox study, a clinical research study of an investigational drug to reduce the number of times you wake up to urinate at night, a condition known as nocturia. To qualify, you must be male, be at least 18 years of age, have been diagnosed with BPH, have been bothered by nocturia for at least 1 year, and meet additional study requirements. Qualified participants will receive all study medication and study-related care from a dedicated team of medical staff at no cost. Health insurance is not required to participate. Again, the Equinox study is for males, ages 18 and older, who are diagnosed with BPH and have been bothered by nocturia for at least 1 year. To find out more and to see if you qualify, please call 1-352-234-8436. That's 1-352-234-8436.
My name is Bo Briggs. I'm a sixth-generation Ocala, and I practice law with my father at the Briggs Law Firm. Over the years, we've seen many changes to Ocala and many changes in our profession. What has not changed is our commitment to our clients. You will speak with and get to know your attorney. That will never change. A lawyer will personally handle your case, not a paralegal. So if you've been injured in an accident and would appreciate personal attention, you can reach us at 671-4600 or learn more at thebriggslawfirm.com.
This is a Fox News Alert. I'm Lillian Wu. Donald Trump chooses a running mate, Indiana Governor Mike Pence. Fox's Rich Edson is in Cleveland, where the RNC kicks off Monday.
The reaction that we have gotten from a number of Republicans here, mostly positive for Mike Pence. There are a number of Republicans who feel and believe that Donald Trump is not a true conservative, doesn't have his conservative bona fides on social issues, on some economic issues, and that Mike Pence would help fill that void.
The Clinton campaign calling Pence incredibly divisive, noting he led the fight to defund Planned Parenthood and opposed raising the federal minimum wage. 3 days of mourning starting tomorrow in France after the deadly truck attack in Nice, which killed at least 84 people. The attacker's ex-wife has been arrested. The president ordering flags at U.S. government facilities, including embassies, to be flown at half staff for the next 4 days. Fox News, we report, you decide.
Hi, can I have 2 steak tacos?
Flour or corn?
Oh, no tortillas. And no steak. Also add turkey, lettuce, and tomato. And just put it between 2 slices of bread.
You know this is a taco truck, right?
As a small business owner, you've got enough to deal with. Let the experts at Progressive insure your business so you can focus on whatever that was. With over 30 commercial, auto, and business coverage options, we'll build a plan that's right for you.
Oh, I'll have Swiss on that, too. Thank you.
Visit ProgressiveCommercial.com to get started. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates.
Focus. You need it to run a business, so don't let legal questions distract you. Use LegalZoom instead. Things like lease agreements and employment laws get complicated, but they're part of running a business. That's why LegalZoom built a network of independent attorneys in 48 states. You can rely on them for the legal details without paying by the hour, since LegalZoom isn't a law firm. So focus on growing your business and use LegalZoom for the legal stuff. LegalZoom. Legal help is here.
This is a public notice.
Local residents can now save thousands of dollars on their next car, truck, or SUV. It's not a tent sale, because no tent is big enough to hold this many cars. It's OcalaForSale.com. Say goodbye to sticker shock. OcalaForSale.com has thousands of vehicles with no stickers at all. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com. Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting less proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
New windows will beautify your home and bring you immediate energy savings. Renewal by Anderson of Central Florida leads the way in quality and installs the name brand homeowners trust. Visit renewalbyanderson.com for a free in-home consultation with the pros. Right now, buy four windows and get the fifth free. Plus, no money down, 0% interest, and zero payments for 12 months with approved credit. Visit renewalbyanderson.com. That's renewalbyanderson.com. Offer ends July 31st. License CGC 1523333.
Hi, I'm Big Daddy Don Garlitz asking you to support adoption by purchasing a Choose Life license plate from your county tag office. You know, it costs a lot to give a child life. Many times a woman is forced to make a bad choice because of financial pressures. Help save the lives of the unborn children by aiding women whom choose life instead of abortion. Take a stand for life. Purchase your Choose Life license plate today. For more information, go to chooselife.org or call 352-624-2854.
Hi, this is Mayor Kent Gwynn. Have you ever wondered what the younger generation thinks? Well, here's the chance to find out. The Mayor and the Millennials coming soon to WOCA 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
WOCA. WOCA.
Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala on a Friday afternoon during Ask the Cops. That means it must be time for the Friday Drive presented by Chris Spears Prestige Auto. Go see Chris Spears, the Yes Man. On the line with us now is Mr. Spears. Chris, how are you today?
Well, I'm almost doing good, as my friend is on the other side of the line as far as the car business and new rides go. Kudos to you, Mr. Schmitz, and your nice newer ride. That Cadillac is pretty and well-deserved. You're a hard-working man, and you have a good spirit, and Buddy brags on you often to me about what a consistent element you are for him and his business there. So kudos to you and this little reward back today.
Well, I know you searched long and hard for that Cadillac SRX that I just bought. So, I kudos to you for finding a great vehicle that I am now very proud to be the owner of.
Awesome. Well, I just had joy in that. We had an awesome month last month and a great start. This week's been almost hectically fun busy. There's problems to have and busy problems are good ones. But a lot of cars. But it's really, I just had a 15-minute meeting with my team on focusing on the people and showing them attention and love coming and going and just getting our minds and hearts right, because that's where service comes from, and that's what people love and enjoy. It's not the car. They're afraid to buy them the car, but if the person with the right heart and spirit gets in the way and focuses on solving their need, not what the manager wants them to sell, good stuff happens. And just had the awesome visits, and your picture I seen an hour ago just joyed me to see you in that nice car.
Well, Chris, this is the time of year where kids, freshmen in college, are getting prepared to go off to school and everything, and if a mom or dad's looking for that good car that's going to get their kid around while at school, is that something you can help a family out with?
Yes, sir. We've got a large selection. I probably at any point have 50 or 60 cars under $10,000, and in that I've got some cars that are $39,000, $49,000, and $59,95. Looking at a 2007 Honda Civic EX Coupe right now, and and just helped a nice lady get a 2004 Honda Civica. So yes, we've got that 1- and 2- and 3-year-old car, but it's not everybody wants to spend, you know, sign up for an $18,000 loan. I read, Tom, about 2 weeks ago that nationally the average new car loan is over $30,000, and our average loan is probably between 7 and 11. So it's that family looking for second car, or somebody that just, you know, whether their heart's just telling them they don't need to get in that much debt on something that's depreciating, you know, 15-20% a year.
Well, Chris, if somebody wanted to come see you this weekend, or they wanted to look at your merchandise, could they find you? Where can they find you on the web? How can they get in touch with you? Where can they come locate you at?
Well, we're a couple doors down from Golden Corral on Highway 200, kind of the sandy corner from Palm Chevrolet. Our website is prestige4u.com, and that, you know, it's the word prestige, the number 4, and then the letter U. Our phone number is, I often want to tell the people to say, well, that's easy, but 694-1234, 694-1234. So it's kind of a nice, easy flow there, but I'd love to visit. And once again, I mentioned on the show that is week in and week out that I help folks in any fashion we can. So I've actually, you know, humbly and grateful to help, have people calling me asking me for a free Carfax, or when I look at a car for them. I've had two people this week bring me their repairs on cars they had that have had the cars for years. They just, you know, got high repair estimates and got on them some additional quotes and some information to go back from. So if you're sitting there, you don't need a car, but my goodness, you just were told this afternoon by a garage you needed to spend, you know, $800 or $1,700 on something, come sit with me, and I'll either say, unfortunately, that's it, or in about 10 minutes, I'll find out that any way I can help, I just love doing that stuff. So come see me at Prestige on 200.
Real quick before I let you go, Chris, for people who are in the situation I'm in, where I just got a new vehicle and I have a vehicle sitting at the house that no longer is needed, is that something people can bring to you? Do you buy vehicles like that from people?
Yes, we have a lot of our inventory, probably 5 cars a week, folks bring me to purchase, and I don't buy them all, but I certainly can point people in a way that can go away. We had one lady brought a car in, it just wasn't worthy of reselling, but we helped her through the auction process that we used to wash out trades, liquidate a car. But yeah, if you've got that car and you think it's too old, we wouldn't buy it. There's a lot of the big box stores. If you show up with your 05 or 07, this, that, and the other, they'll say, we don't buy that, but go see Chris at Prestige. And yes, the other part of it, if you don't want to deal with, you know, internet troubles or Craigslist crazies, then we do take cars on consignment, and that keeps you, you know, at arm's length from the stuff, but still the ability to get a better than wholesale value for your car, and but yet not have to worry about, you know, fake cashier's checks or a bunch of hoodlums coming in wanting to take your Buick for a ride.
Chris Spears, go see him, the Yes Man at Prestige Auto. Chris, have a great weekend.
I will, sir. And Corey, I appreciate what you guys do down there to keep us safe and protected. And I was raised at law enforcement in my family and around me, and have always admired the hard work that you guys do. And just appreciate you guys and everything that you've done, and always will.
Thank you very much.
Chris Spears. Bye now. Chris Spears of Prestige Auto. That's always a good segment we do. So we were talking before we went to break, a couple of things we need to hit back on is, one is, let's take a phone call first. We got a guy that wants to talk to you. Go ahead, Hugh, you're on with Captain Taylor.
Thank you very much, and thank you, Captain. A quick question. What is the procedure recommended to the police officers when there is there could be a fast pursuit vehicle through the city limits?
Hey, thanks for the call, Hugh. So he said, what is the procedure in place now for high-speed chases or pursuits through the city limits?
Gotcha. For us, our pursuits, we only pursue vehicles because, again, when you think, I'll always reference, you know, ultimately what our mission is, but when you think about protecting life and property, we've fashioned our current policy so as to make sure that those remain focused in the officer's mind. So we will pursue for all violent, all violent felonies, serious offenses, that the offender needs to be apprehended on. We give the officer the discretion of also pursuing vehicles for moving violations. But in both cases, whether it's something that in a pursuit that the officer believes to be something that, like I said, a moving violation that he initiates for, or something where it's a violent felon that we're pursuing for. In both cases, we're always constantly, considering the situation at hand, the different factors that are taking place, and we're always, continually monitoring and making a determination whether or not it's appropriate to continue or if we need to discontinue.
So pursuits can be discontinued even after they've been undertaken?
That is correct.
Yep. I did not. I thought once you were pursuing, you pursued it till it was over.
No, because again, circumstances change, situations change. And so if a pursuit, ultimately at the end of the day, if a pursuit becomes more dangerous than the reason that we initiated it for, then there's no reason to continue. And so we can discontinue. And that can be done at the officer's level or at a supervisory level above them.
Very good. We were talking about preparedness and how preparation is paramount to you doing and the men and women in blue doing a effective job. That you must be prepared at all times. That's why when you ever see people say, I went back to my training. Mm-hmm. I went back to my training. When you think about that, is there anything that you could think of, though, that would have prepared any kind of, I mean, anything in your training that said, be aware of a panel truck plowing through thousands of people?
Absolutely not. Because again, I mean, that's just not something that you think of. I mean, we plan for plane crashes and train crashes
and active shooters and stuff.
Active shooters, yeah. But but we never, you can never really prepare yourself for something like that, which is why, if you base everything that you do on this tenet of, we need to, protect, protect life, protect property, then you can kind of find your way, from there.
I bet from now on there will start being some trainings given on how to, because I as you watched the video, some of the cell phone video yesterday, there were police officers, French police officers on motorcycles trying to get up beside the guy, and they knew what was coming. He had done run through two road checks. They knew what were coming. And they were trying to get there and get shots into the cab from beside, but he was just swerving into him, knocking the motorcycle cops off their
thing. Right.
Just a tragedy all around.
Very much so. Very much so.
Before we went to break, the first break, I asked you a question, and I wanted you to think about it for a while, and then I come back to it. But going back to the talk of race relations. And right now, the country is seeing that officers, and it doesn't matter the color of skin, it's because you have a badge on, are under siege in some places. No further evidence is needed than to show you, than to talk about what happened in Dallas.
Yes, sir.
Where officers who were there to make sure a peaceful protest was just that, a peaceful protest, and Americans were able to use their civil liberties to protest the way the Constitution grants them the right to do. And some person decided to take aim at the police officer that were there to protect and serve. By the way, in a city, Dallas, who race relations wise and cop to citizens wise is a very good city.
Exactly.
It's a very good city. So it was ironic it was that city. But do you find that it is at times easier or harder on you as a man of color being a police officer?
I would say neither. I don't think the color of my skin really defines defines the type of job that I do or I don't think it really has any control over the the difficulties or the benefits that I that I face. I think I don't think I'm different than any other police officer that wears a uniform. It's actually the experiences that I have as a man that really define and make things easier. Some of the conversation we were having on break, everybody goes has been through something. I always I have the opportunity to teach at the academy level at CF, and the one of the things I always tell them when we're talking is that one bad decision defined really differentiates makes the difference between you sitting in this seat preparing to be a police officer as well as the people on the other side of the coin that we are, you know, enforcing, just one bad decision. And so it's really those experiences that we go through as life, the things that, you know, that happened in my house, how I was raised, you know, how we were talking about, those really define, you know, who I am as a police officer and make it, you know, less difficult or more difficult for me.
And just as one bad decision by an officer in, and we don't know until the investigation is done if it was a bad decision, but allegedly in Minnesota or allegedly in Louisiana, somehow the human psyche lets that trump all the great decisions that are made on a moment-by-moment and minute-by-minute basis by men and women with a badge on all over the country. We look at those two bad incidents, but think about the thousands and thousands of incidents on a daily basis that go exactly the way they're supposed to go. People don't want to think about, we only want to harp on the things when they're bad. We don't want to tell about how great it was a sergeant in Ocala stops and has lunch with a homeless person. We don't want that. We want the, he was laying on top of it when he shot him. That's what we want as humans, and it sickens me at times that that's what we key in on.
Well, I mean, and I'm a glass half full kind of person, and even though right now it's interesting how the narrative when people talk about the Dallas situation, the narrative right now is really the focus is on the guy that was behind the scope on the rifle. But what I actually saw was the number of police officers that were out there, you know, standing and laying over people to protect them.
Certainly.
And to me, that should be the narrative. That really should be, you know, what we as Americans are keying in on, and that the fact that those police officers are out there, you know, really trying to do their jobs and not give attention to the man that, you know.
I don't think the narrative has ever said enough that when we are in a situation to run, you men and women in blue with badges are in a situation where you turn and run too, but you run towards what we're running from.
You're right.
That's the difference. We both run, but we run away and you run towards.
Yes, sir.
And that's just what you've agreed to do.
It is.
And I thank you for that.
Thank you.
We're going to come back. When we come back, we'll let you tell us if there's any kind of community events or anything that you want to tell us about that involved the police department, because I know during the summer there's a bunch of them.
Oh, yes, sir.
We'll talk about that next on Ask the Cops, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Are you in need of custom screen printing, embroidery, or promotional items? Then look no further and come visit the brand new Legacy Team Sales. LTS is conveniently located off 17th Street next to Armstrong Homes in beautiful Ocala. We offer the best prices and highest quality products for your company, team, school, or nonprofit. Whether looking for screen printed shirts, embroidered polos, or travel team uniforms, you'll be sure to find it at Legacy Team Sales. Come visit our new 27,000 square foot facility. Our friendly and knowledgeable sales staff will assist you in every part of your custom purchase. LTS carries the hottest brands in the industry like Under Armour, Russell, Mizuno, Asics, Badger Sports, Gildan, Pacific, OGO, and many more. At LTS, screen printing embroidery is done in-house and we guarantee customer satisfaction. Stop by, give us a call, or check us out on the web at shoplts.com. Remember the name, LTS.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
The bonus of exercising at night? It's because our body uses oxygen more efficiently. Now, most of us associate dementia and Alzheimer's with memory loss, of course. But with FTD, people with this disorder start acting out and behaving in ways that are way out of character. 10-second fix for anxiety. You start thinking of or writing down as many ice cream flavors as you can think of in 10 seconds.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
That was the sound of a tree falling. It could be your tree. You're going to have it trimmed, but never got around to calling Pride Tree Service. It could have fallen in a field, and now all you have to do is call Pride Tree Service, and they'll have it quickly out of the way for a great price. But don't wait until the tree falls. It may not fall in the field. It may hit your car, your house, or worse. So call Pride Tree Service today and avoid all those headaches before they happen. Pride Tree Service, 572-2510. That's 572-2510.
Welcome back to Ask the Cops. We're talking to Captain Corey Taylor of the Ocala Police Department. He is the East Watch Commander. Is that correct? No, no. East
District Commander.
District Commander. Watch Commander is what lieutenants are.
That is correct.
You're a District Commander.
Yes, sir.
The whole East Side belongs to you.
So to speak.
So to speak. Now, this is the time of the show when we ask if there's any kind of community involvement in the police department. And that, by the way, that's one of the qualities of the police department, is how much community involvement there is. Because that, I think that goes back to that respect. The community respects that you involve them in the everyday process of the police department.
That is correct.
Now, is there anything coming up? I know you got summer camps. I know you got all kind of things where you get kids involved.
Right.
Tell us some of the things that we can look for coming up here with the police department.
We have one main event that I'd like to talk about. The summer camp that you spoke of, that's our PAC, the Police and Children Connecting. That is entering its final week next week. And the kids have had a wonderful time. The Sergeant Bonner and the group that's responsible for that, I think they've taken them over 60 field trips. They've been to medieval times. And so they've had a great time. But the event that I did want to talk about on Saturday, July 23rd, begin at 12 o'clock, and it's slated to run about 2 hours, ending at 2. We have what we've dubbed Picnic with Your Police. And essentially, basically, we're just looking for an opportunity in a relaxed, casual, relaxed setting to be able to connect with our the citizens that we serve. One of the things you and I talked about earlier, we were talking about this phraseology, the concepts of connecting, that if we connect and we come around and get together with one another, then ultimately we begin to communicate. Through communication comes an understanding. Understanding then will translate into respect and ultimately trust. And trust is that component that we need to be able to kind of carry out our community policing concept. So at this event, it'll be at Spring Manor Apartments. This will be the first one. It's 2833 Northeast 7th Street.
We all know Spring Manor was a place that there was some crime issues here a year or so ago.
There were, and they've the owners of the facility have done a lot, to fix quality of life issues and really kind of raise up the immune system of the community.
So now, what day is this again?
It's Saturday, July 23rd,
from 12 to 2 p.m. at Spring Manor on 7th. If you don't know where that is, go to the Montessori School. Take a left at the Montessori School, in between Wendy's and the Montessori School. Go down to 7th, take a left, and the apartment complex is on your right.
That's it. That's it.
That's how I go to the golf course from my house. Well, Captain, it's been great to have you in here. Been great to meet you. And, next time you drive by the golf course, beep. I'll probably be there.
I will.
Captain Corey Taylor of the Ocala Police Department. This has been Ask the Cops. Coming up next, hour number 2, we'll get into this whole tragedy in France. Plus Hunter Turner at 4:30. We're talking the British Open right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
My name is Bo Briggs. I'm a 6th-generation Ocalan. I practice law with my father at the Briggs Law Firm. Over the years, we've seen many changes to Ocala and many changes in our profession. What has not changed is our commitment to our clients. You will speak with and get to know your attorney. That will never change. A lawyer will personally handle your case, not a paralegal. So if you've been injured in an accident and would appreciate personal attention, you can reach us at 671-4600 or learn more at thebriggslawfirm.com.
There's a car accident in this country every 5 seconds. That's why Allstate thinks it's time for an entirely different kind of car insurance, with features like accident forgiveness and a safe driving bonus. It's called Your Choice Auto, and it's only from Allstate. Are you in good hands?
You deserve better. Sign up for Your Choice Auto from Allstate. Call the McDonnell Agency today at 622-2333.
Features are optional and subject to terms, conditions, and availability. Allstate Insurance, Northbrook, Illinois.
Your quality of life is meant to be fully enjoyed each day. The doctors at Ayers Global understand that and strive to provide a quality of life for you that has no equal. Ayers Therapeutic Services combines naturopathic and family medicine to help all your health needs. Diabetic management, hypertension, pain management, and anti-aging are just a few of the services offered by the Ayers family. Call 352-512-0222 today, and Ayers Therapeutic Services will help you begin to understand that better health begins with you.
Are you in the process of planning your wedding reception? Or are you planning that birthday party for someone special? Or maybe you're just looking to throw a party for yourself. Are you in charge of this year's company outing and looking for something fresh and fun to do? Well, KT Entertainment is your answer to all those questions. We provide music, trivia, and karaoke for everybody's enjoyment. If you would like to get in touch with KT Entertainment and find out about our competitive prices, call us at 352-512-2611. That's 352-512-2611. Or you can find us on the web at kt4fun.com. That's KT, the number 4, fun.com. So remember, whether it's a wedding reception, a party, or a company outing, it's KT Entertainment for all your karaoke, trivia, or musical needs.
Keep up with what's going on in the downtown area with Ocala Downtown Newspaper. Delivering thousands of newspapers to businesses in the downtown area, Ocala Downtown is there to keep you informed. They even have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask in return is that you tell them where you heard about it. It's simple. For more info, just call Tom's Picks, 352-804-1223, and pick up your copy of the Downtown Ocala Newspaper today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
Baumgarten of Ocala leads in the area of orthopedic care with proven outcomes. Planning to have a new hip or knee joint due to arthritis or as the result of a fall, Baumgarten may be the answer. Guests appreciate the services of highly trained therapists and state-of-the-art equipment. And if you pre-register, you can secure a private room at no extra charge by mentioning this ad. Baumgarten makes no bones about it. They provide the best in orthopedic care. Call 854-6262. That's 854-6262.
You can't put it off any longer. It's time to replace your home's AC system.
The answer is AceSolvesItAll.com and an exceptionally efficient AC system. Let the pros at Ace show you how you can save on energy monthly and give your family added comfort. The great thing is that AceSolvesItAll.com is on call 7-7, 7 days a week at no extra charge.
For a limited time, mention WOCA and get a special discount.
Call 877-765-4ACE or AceSolvesItAll.com.
Yeah, I'm that drip coming down from the corner of the room. But where did I come from? I'll never tell.
Home Dry Roofing can and will fix it right the first time using quality materials and will deal honestly and fairly with you, period. You can find Bone Dry Roofing on their website, BoneDryRoofingLLC.com, and Facebook at Bone Dry Roofing LLC. Do it right before your roof needs a tarp to keep the elements out. Bone Dry Roofing stands behind their work to help make your home safe and secure. Plus, they have financing available. Remember, if you're not bone dry, then you're all wet.
Putting the local back into radio. 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. WOCA News. Variety. Information. Now. Keep your arms and legs on the inside at all times.
If you want to avoid getting ripped off and put more money in your pocket, then join me, Clark Howard, every weeknight at 6, right here on WOCA The Source.
We are The Source. WOCA. Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Carol McHugh. President Obama says our hearts are with the French people. Vigils are being held across France nearly 24 hours after a Tunisian-born French national drove a truck through crowds in Nice celebrating Bastille Day. 84 are dead, more than 200 wounded. The truck driver was killed by police. Donald Trump has named his running mate, Indiana Governor Mike Pence.
This morning, Donald Trump made the pick official on Twitter. The Trump-Pence campaign has also released a new logo featuring a T and P interlocked.
Fox's Jared Halpern in Cleveland. Trump's official introduction of Pence will take place in New York tomorrow at 11 a.m. In Baton Rouge, Louisiana, funerals held for Alton Sterling, a black man who died in a confrontation with white cops.
Sterling's death was one of two incidents last week prompting outrage regarding African-American deaths during police confrontations.
Fox's Evan Brown, Fox News. We report, you decide.
Hi, can I have two steak tacos?
Flour or corn?
Oh, no tortillas. And no steak. Also add turkey, lettuce, and tomato. And just put it between two slices of bread.
You know this is a taco truck, right?
As a small business owner, you've got enough to deal with. Let the experts at Progressive insure your business so you can focus on whatever that was. With over 30 commercial, auto, and business coverage options, we'll build a plan that's right for you.
Oh, I'll have Swiss on that too. Thank you.
Visit ProgressiveCommercial.com to get started. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates.
Focus. You need it to run a business, so don't let legal questions distract you. Use LegalZoom instead. Things like lease agreements and employment laws get complicated, but they're part of running a business. That's why LegalZoom built a network of independent attorneys in 48 states. You can rely on them for the legal details without paying by the hour, since LegalZoom isn't a law firm. So focus on growing your business and use LegalZoom for the legal stuff. LegalZoom. Legal help is here.
It's time again for Buddy Martin. Call him up and tell him what you're thinking. But be kind, because he's doing the best he can.
I'm just sick of all the amateur stuff, you know? I mean, like, if I'm paying top dollar, I want a little production value, you know? Like some editing, transition, something, some music.
Don't worry, we didn't leave you.
He's gone? He's not gone! That's the whole point! He's never gone!
Our bosses say we gotta stay.
Check out the name tag. You're in my world now, Grandma.
Bow to your sensei. Bow to your sensei!
It's time for the second hour of The Voice of Ocala.
Hoo-ah!
You ever come across anything like time travel?
Come on, stick around. It's free.
If you win, you win. If you lose, you still win.
Welcome back to hour number two of The Voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin. Buddy Martin dealing with some issues, fallout from the storm yesterday. Wow. And what a storm we had yesterday afternoon. Over near the McPherson Complex, back behind on 7th, behind the Publix Plaza, there were power lines out and pictures of live power lines creating fires and everything, and then trees laying across the road on 25th, and just a mess yesterday afternoon. And it was one of those storms that you didn't, it just looked like it was going to be a normal Florida storm, normal Florida afternoon storm, and it blew up into this just maniacal evil storm. And it just, I mean, I was driving through that area this morning, and there are people just out with chainsaws and big, I mean, large trees down. And Buddy's dealing with some of those tree issues as well at his house, so he's not going to be able to make it in today. Everyone is safe though. No structural damage to the house or anything. Tree just fell along the back part of his property, but it's a big tree that needs to be taken care of. So he is handling that. So you got me for the second hour as well. Buddy will be checking in with us at about 4:15 though. We'll talk about the news of the day. Donald Trump names his running mate. They'll hold a press conference tomorrow. it is Governor Pence from Indiana. But the story, the news that is just everywhere today is, once again, we had an attack of the human race yesterday. This guy who drove a big panel van, like, you know, one of those big rental trucks you get that's like 26, 28 feet long? That's what it looks like to me he was driving. And it maybe wasn't longer. I'm trying to pull up the stats on it now. But they've identified the assailant now. He is, the suspected terrorist killed dozens of people, including at least 10 children, by plowing a truck into a crowd in France during Bastille Day celebrations Thursday night. He's been identified. He's a 31-year-old Mohamed Bohil, who was unknown to French security services. He was born in Tunisia, lived in Nice with his wife, and worked as a delivery driver. Officials recovered an automatic handgun, grenade, and ammunition from his truck, among other weapons and items. Investigators also seized computers and cell phones during searches at two different addresses. This man was entirely unknown by intelligence services and had no file of radicalization. He was sentenced in March to a six-month suspended prison sentence for use of a weapon. It was in a roads rage incident between him and another a vehicle. Two Americans, among at least the 84, killed in the attack when the driver mowed down a large crowd with a truck hauling grenades and other weapons during Bastille Day. This according to the U.S. State Department. Sean Copeland and his 11-year-old son, Brody, who were in Nice on a family vacation, were killed in the attack. Alyssa Weaver, the elder Copeland's niece, wrote on Twitter, "The Copelands are from Lakeway, Texas." That's about 30 miles west of Austin. So two Americans are known to be killed. Three UC Berkeley students studying abroad in Nice were injured in the attack, the university said. One student sustained two broken legs. Another had a broken foot. Another UC Berkeley student is still unaccounted for. France prosecutors said, in addition to those killed, including 10 children, more than 200 others were injured. Among them, 52 were in critical condition. So just a terrible, terrible tragedy took place in Nice, France, yesterday during a celebration of Bastille Day. And for those people that don't know, Bastille Day is the equivalent in France to the 4th of July here. It is the day that the peasant class decided they had had enough with the bourgeoisie class and stormed the Bastille to seize weapons to start the French Revolution in 1789. So this was in celebration of the beginning of the French Revolution, 1789, just as we celebrate the beginning of our Declaration of our Independence on July 4th. So these people were in a large crowd staring up at the sky looking at fireworks when this truck plowed through them at high speed. Witnesses described a festive night. Shortly after the fireworks ended, people were walking down the promenade when she heard when people heard gunshots. They started running. People just didn't have any time to jump out of the way, some witnesses say. Chaos erupted as people tried to flee the driver's deadly path. One woman said, "I started running. I looked back. I saw the truck going through the people right in the place where I was standing. It was just seconds. A woman next to me stumbled and fell. People kept running over her, and I was trying to pick her up so she could also run." So just a terrible, terrible situation that took place in Nice, France last night, but not surprising. I heard one guy say, "Look, it's a tourist said, I don't know why I came over here. It just seems like it's really not safe right now in France." And it does seem that France is the epicenter of a lot of these terrorism attacks in Europe. So hearts go out to those involved. It's the new news cycle. Now it's France. 3 weeks ago, it was 4 weeks ago, it was Orlando. Then it was Dallas. Now it's France. And just goes hopping around the world. And there comes a time when the leaders, the most powerful nation in the free world, has to step in and say enough. I firmly believe that there has to come a time when the most powerful nation in the free world has to say, this is enough, and step in with all the resources and revenue and might and say enough. I just don't know when our government's going to say that time is. We're going to take a break. When we come back, Buddy Martin joins us right here on The Voice of Ocala on a Friday afternoon, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with their clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz.
Hi, I'm State Farm agent Angie Lewis. Come see me and my team for all your insurance and financial needs in the beautiful downtown historic district, 416 East Fort King Street, or call 291-2444.
Do you remember when summer was a celebration? You know, no schools, no worries, just days packed with your favorite pastime. It was the splendid season you dreamed of all year long. But as you got older and busier, the summer seemed to lose its sparkle. Where did those carefree days go? Well, they're closer than you think. Summer's still sensational at Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club, where you can come out and play the grown-up way with our affordable summer memberships. Enjoy our championship golf course celebrating the game's greatest holes, hard-true tennis courts, and a state-of-the-art fitness center. Explore our stately 77,000-square-foot clubhouse and unwind at our relaxing spa.
Don't forget the pool!
It's a summer unlike any other, and it's yours with a Golden Ocala summer membership. You can call Golden Ocala at 629-6229 to inquire about a summer membership, or you can visit goldenocala.com to learn more. That's goldenocala.com.
Your quality of life is meant to be fully enjoyed each day. The doctors at Ayers Global understand that and strive to provide a quality of life for you that has no equal. Ayers Therapeutic Services combines naturopathic and family medicine to help all your health needs. Diabetic management, hypertension, pain management, and anti-aging are just a few of the services offered by the Ayers family. Call 352-512-0222 today, and Ayers Therapeutic Services will help you begin to understand that better health begins with you.
Hi, I'm Big Daddy Don Garlitz, asking you to support adoption by purchasing a Choose Life license plate from your county tag office. You know, it costs a lot to give a child life. Many times a woman is forced to make a bad choice because of financial pressures. Help save the lives of the unborn children by aiding women whom choose life instead of abortion. Take a stand for life. Purchase your Choose Life license plate today. For more information, go to chooselife.org or call 352-624-2854.
Cookies, 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 cookies. We go cookie eating cookies.
When you want something special and fun for any occasion, get cookies. King Cookie in the Paddock Mall in Ocala will make a delicious, fun-filled delight just for you. So next time you're in the mall, stop by King Cookie or call 352-237-2557. KingCookieOcala.com. Customized cookies, cakes, and more. King Cookie.
Eating cookies, we're so happy eating cookies. Cookies!
Career Source Citrus Levy Marion brings together business and community partners, economic development leaders, and educational providers to connect employers with qualified, skilled talent and job seekers with employment and career development opportunities. Tune in the first and third Wednesday of each month at 9:30 a.m. to Career Source Citrus Levy Marion and learn how they can help you.
Hi, this is Mayor Kent Gwynn. Have you ever wondered what the younger generation thinks? Well, here's the chance to find out. The Mayor and the Millennials coming soon to WOCA 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
WWWWOCA. WWWWWOCA.
1370 WOCA.
Welcome back to The Voice of Ocala on a Friday afternoon. Let's go out to the phone lines and talk to a guy who would like to be in studio, but the storm yesterday got some things, got some trees in his yard that made it where he wasn't possible to come in today, but he's here with us on the phone lines. Buddy Martin, now, buddy, you put the chainsaw down long enough to come in and take the phone call?
Yeah. If there ain't no way that chainsaw, that I have to wait for a while. My chainsaw days are over with. I used to have one in my house up in New York, and this is a big old tree. You saw it. It's huge. I mean,
it really is a big tree.
And we thought it was next door neighbor, as ours said.
A lot of cleanup from yesterday's storm, and it just shows you these storms can come out of nowhere. You need to be prepared because these storms can come fast and ferocious.
Well, he told us, the guy came over and did the, our guy who's doing the tree for us, tree and tree, said that there's quite a few big trees around Ocala that came down, huge water oaks. So there's some, obviously quite a bit of damage in our city, which we haven't seen yet. At least I haven't seen it yet. So I know when it cracked here, man, it frightened us. So anyway, that's something odd. Just lucky nobody got hit. You know, no real property damage other than the fence and a few things, and nobody got hurt. That's the big thing. Because these trees, man, they didn't seem like they used to have as many trees coming down like this. I don't know what it is.
Well, those water oaks are notorious for coming down in wind like that. And that yesterday was, that wasn't your ordinary wind and thunderstorm.
No.
That was the National Weather Service actually sent somebody to the Ocala area to investigate whether that was a tornado or just a microburst that came through yesterday.
Yeah, because you saw the might of that huge tree. You couldn't put your arms around it, so big. You might put your tree hands halfway around and about 50 feet tall. That tree coming down, then hit another tree and cut it in half, and that tree was big. You might could have got your arms around that tree if you're lucky. So it cracked it right off. So that tree, imagine the force falling on a house or on somebody, could break another tree in half like that, right, you know, about 30 feet up in the big part of the trunk. So. And it wasn't a dead tree, you know, so that's scary.
I watched a big water oak like that out of the Muni. It fell. It was about an 85-foot-tall water oak, and it fell into about an 80-foot pine tree and snapped that pine tree like it was nothing.
Yeah. So. You don't think about it, but it's dangerous out there, so.
Very dangerous. Speaking of dangerous, buddy, the news out of Paris is not good. There's three Berkeley students that were injured, one still missing, two Americans, a father and son, killed in this attack. And, you know, we know about active shooters. We know about suicide bombers. We know about those, you know, terrorists that set bombs and then fly airplanes into buildings. We know all that. A panel van, a delivery truck at high speed through a large crowd. I have to tell you, it surprised me as a motive operandi.
Well, and it's not a guy that the intelligence people knew, because he wasn't, to their knowledge, associated with the detective group. And he was, however, a well-known criminal with a history of violence and breaking in places. 31-year-old Tunisian. He said had a gun and just rode through the French Riviera there and started shooting, running over people. What horror, that have happened. And 10 children killed among those, the 84. So, you know, and you just, it's just hard to get your mind around things like that. Anybody could be that evil, and that's what it is, pure out evil, who want to take the life of people they don't know for whatever cause. And it seems like that ISIL, although we don't know that he was connected to ISIL, just is made for people like that. They don't care about their lives, and they think they have a cause, so they decided to just go kill people. What? I don't get that. I missed that somewhere along the way. And this guy's name was Mohammed Laqai or something, and Bulail was his name. And he shot in a crowd who was gathered for Bastille Day.
Yeah,
and he just sort of started running over people, and for a mile before they finally caught him. And it just goes to show you, Tom, if one person, one lone wolf, wants to wreak damage and kill people, they can do it, and there's not much you can do about it. So that's the scary part.
82 dead, over 200 injured, 52 still in critical condition.
Mm-hmm.
Just really, really crazy. I got this breaking news, buddy. I don't know if you're sitting in front of your television or not. There's an attempted military coup underway in Turkey, in the Turkish capital of Ankara. There's a military coup underway. ABC News is reporting, and that, you know, the people think that they're unsafe, and there was a, you know, there was a, the destruction in the airport in Turkey, and people think maybe the country's unsafe and unstable, and these are the kind of fallouts that you see in these kind of situations, you know, because Turkey was the, what, 3 weeks ago there was a terrorist attack at the airport in Turkey, and now looks like the military says, look, we're going to have to take over this country to get bring it back, you know, to safety. But you never want to see a country run by the military.
Yeah, it's all over that, all over the Middle East and parts of Europe right now. France, I mean, I saw a map earlier, I guess it was this morning, the number of terrorist attacks France has had.
Yeah.
They've had a bunch of them, you know, and we've had a few of our own. But I mean, it seems like that there's so many of these things, and you think, how do you fight stuff like that? How do you deal with people like that? You know, you just, at some point, there's going to have to be an uprising, an awakening of people to realize that they're going to have to start policing themselves, and evil is going to have to be routed out somehow, because it's the worst kind of evil, the kind of just lurks next door to you, and then one day you wake up and realize that this person is a killer, and a being vicious killer, and not just a killer. There are people who kill people, and there are people who kill domestically in their family. These are people, are random acts killing people they don't even know, and senselessly ending lives for no reason other than their own selfish motivation. So, I don't know. It's just a difficult thing for us to comprehend. I lay awake nights sometimes thinking, how do we get in this mess, and what do we do to correct it? And it's just not a clear cut thing. I don't know. Where do you go? Who do you talk to? What do you do? All I come up with is one answer. You better pray. That's about it.
You know, I don't know that there's any other solution right now except through faith, and just that the faith that we'll continue on as a people, and that these kind of fringe situations will be eventually brought under control. That's how I go to sleep at night, buddy.
Yeah, and our hearts and prayers and thoughts go to those people in France, and it seems like it's every week now. So I wonder how this will reflect, how this can reflect ultimately in politics and political change. And we talked about this some yesterday on our show, with all the issues we got, bad enough that we have in our own country. We have disrespect, and we have one faction fighting another, fighting, killing people, and what have you. But now we have this overlay with this terrorism and some of these nutbags out there who are have no value on life. So yeah, it's I see that, you know, people are beginning to think maybe this will help Donald Trump. You know, maybe they think Donald Trump will be more likely to go out and start shooting people or doing something. And in a situation like this, you do get frustrated. You say, well, let's just go identify who these people are, where they are, and just start bombing them, you know?
Well,
that's how you start thinking.
That's the problem, though, buddy, is this guy, wouldn't have been able to identify this guy. He was on no watch list. No, he was not known. He was known as a petty criminal in France.
Right.
But not as a guy who was known to the France intelligence, not a guy who was known to be associated with any extremist groups. He was just, from all looks of it, he looked like a guy who had a wife, and he drove a delivery van, and he every now and then did something that was a petty criminal issues, but nothing to the volume of where he was going to mow down hundreds of people and kill 82 people.
Right. Like I said, it's early on when we started talking, it's just no one knows where the enemy is, but I said the frustration level of you. When you get frustrated, you start thinking, let's just go get them up on the radar if we know where some of these people are, and just start sending missiles in there. That's our thinking. That, of course, is not the right thing to do. But the anger level and the fear level is at all time high. You know, where that you think, who can I strike back at? And of course, that's never the answer. But that's what makes you think.
I am surprised, and I will say this: I am surprised that the level of striking back has not escalated in recent weeks. Because you know, it did after 9/11. people that looked of Middle Eastern descent and all were they faced a very hard time, even in this country, especially in this country after that. And you know, it's not the proper thing to do by any means. But I'm pleasantly surprised that the vigilante aspect hasn't taken hold yet.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. I think that's far much going to worry about. So hopefully, in some fashion, cooler heads prevail. We've been very lucky. We haven't had more of those things happen in our country. We had 9/11, of course, and that was pretty bad, actually. But I guess maybe our security people are doing a little better job than what we thought. Who knows? Who knows the things we don't hear about? You know, there are things every day that happen in Homeland Security that, well, we've had people on our show to talk about that we never know about. And so, consequently, it's almost where you don't want to turn your television set on, or you don't want to have any Fox or CNN. You say, you know what, today I want to watch a golf tournament, you know, or I want to watch a baseball game. I just don't want to deal with it because you think, what can I do? And all I can do is get depressed about it. So,
well,
again, thoughts and prayers to the people in France.
Certainly. And I'll leave you with this, buddy. You hit on a good point. On Tuesday, after the Dallas shootings last week and everything, I opened the newspaper, the Ocala Star Banner, and I went right to the life section and read Dear Abby, because I said, I'll read this first. That way I'll start with something that doesn't depress me. I'll read Dear Abby first.
Yeah, and I was at last night, La Cuisine, our friends up to elevating Patrice, was Bastille Day there. We knew there was something had happened at that point. 10 people were reported dead, but there were tons of people there last night. It was jam-packed, and we were chance to speak with Elodie and Patrice about it, and we said Vive la France and all that. They're such neat people. They bring a lot to our community. So,
Buddy Martin, take care of that tree, and we'll see you back in here Monday,
all right,
buddy.
Tom. Thank you, Tom. Have a good day.
Uh-huh. Coming up next, Hunter Turner joins us to talk the British Open right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Who doesn't love heading out on the boat with a family, hitting the ATV trails with friends, or blazing new stretches of highway with riding buddies? Your toys are your ticket to outdoor fun. At the McDonald Allstate Agency, we get to know you and help make sure you have all the right coverages. Plus, when you bundle your coverage for your car and your home with your boat, motorcycle, RV, or more, you can save up to 30%. So call the McDonald Allstate Agency today at 622-2333 or stop by one of our two Ocala locations at Cala Hills or the Jasmine Square Plaza.
Subject to terms, conditions, and availability. Savings vary.
Hello, I'm Dawn Lovell, lead event designer and owner at Party Time Rentals. Have you ever wondered what it takes to make an event spectacular? Well, look no further. It's what we do every day. Whether you're hosting an intimate dinner for 10 or a gala for thousands, at Party Time Rentals, we find just the right style and elegance to make your event a success. Our extensive inventory of the finest in chandeliers, tents, crystal, china, and specialty items is featured in our fabulous showroom. Stop by and say hello. It's a great way to get ideas for an event and experience for yourself how you can make your party time special.
Party Time Rentals, located on Southwest 10th Street, just off Route 200 in Ocala, and off Southwest 34th Street in Gainesville. For more information, call 352-629-8858. That's 352-629-8858. The party begins at Party Time.
Hello, everybody. This is Terry Bradshaw, Fox NFL Sunday. Whenever I'm in Ocala, if I'm not singing and singing with my buddy Mel Tillis, then I'm listening to my longtime friend Buddy Martin on WOCA. Of course, I rarely get to Ocala, so if you believe that, I've got some horses I'd like to sell you. Some of them even have four legs. Regardless, I highly recommend you listen to Buddy Martin's Sports Page weekdays at 5 p.m. right here on The Source.
News Radio, I'm Carol McHugh. President Obama says our hearts are with the French people. Vigils are being held across France nearly 24 hours after a Tunisian-born French national drove a truck through crowds in Nice celebrating Bastille Day. 84 are dead, more than 200 wounded. The truck driver was killed by police. Donald Trump has named his running mate, Indiana Governor Mike Pence.
This morning, Donald Trump made the pick official on Twitter. The Trump-Pence campaign has also released a new logo featuring a T and P interlocked.
Fox's Jaron Halpern in Cleveland. Trump's official introduction of Pence will take place in New York tomorrow at 11 a.m. In Baton Rouge, Louisiana, funerals held for Alton Sterling, a black man who died in a confrontation with white cops.
Sterling's death was one of two incidents last week prompting outrage regarding African-American deaths during police confrontations.
Fox's Evan Brown, Fox News. We report, you decide.
Hi, can I have two steak tacos?
Flour or corn?
Oh, no tortillas. And no steak. Also add turkey, lettuce, and tomato. And just put it between two slices of bread.
You know this is a taco truck, right?
As a small business owner, you've got enough to deal with. Let the experts at Progressive insure your business so you can focus on whatever that was. With over 30 commercial, auto, and business coverage options, we'll build a plan that's right for you.
Oh, I'll have Swiss on that, too. Thank you.
Visit ProgressiveCommercial.com to get started. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates.
Focus. You need it to run a business, so don't let legal questions distract you. Use LegalZoom instead. Things like lease agreements and employment laws get complicated, but they're part of running a business. That's why LegalZoom built a network of independent attorneys in 48 states. You can rely on them for the legal details without paying by the hour, since LegalZoom isn't a law firm. So focus on growing your business and use LegalZoom for the legal stuff. LegalZoom. Legal help is here.
New windows will beautify your home and bring you immediate energy savings. Renewal by Anderson of Central Florida leads the way in quality and installs the name brand homeowners trust. Visit renewalbyanderson.com for a free in-home consultation with the pros. Right now, buy four windows and get the fifth free. Plus, no money down, 0% interest, and zero payments for 12 months with approved credit. Visit renewalbyanderson.com. That's renewalbyanderson.com. Offer ends July 31st. License CGC 1523333.
This is Kendall Carpenter with Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club. I want to introduce you to the finest equestrian opportunity available. If you love horses and enjoy Central Florida's mild climate and rich rolling landscape, come explore Golden Ocala. Bridle trails weave their way through this stunningly beautiful community of stately homes. Our state-of-the-art equestrian center will meet all of your equestrian needs with style. Visit us at goldenocala.com.
Need to sell your house? Discover how to easily sell your house fast and for full price in today's market. Join us live this Friday, 9:30 a.m. for Mr. Ocala Real Estate Today. Sell your house now. Full price, fast close. Guaranteed. Call 352-282-3080. 352-282-3080. And join us live right here, 9:30 a.m. Friday.
Putting the local back into radio. 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. WOCA News. Variety. Information. Now. Keep your arms and legs on the inside at all times.
When it really counts, depend on the source for the latest weather updates. Keeping you ahead of the storm. 96.3 FM, 1370 AM, The Source.
Visit the WOCA website at www.wOCA.com.
Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala on a Friday afternoon. It's starting to cloud up. That afternoon thunderstorm is on its way, so keep a watch on your radars. We'll keep giving you weather updates periodically here at WOCA. But right now on the phone lines, a guy who is the golf guru now. I'm Mr. Golf, but he's taken over as the golf guru, and he's here to talk the Open Championship, the 145th Open Championship, the British Open to us Yanks, is golf guru Hunter Turner. Hunter, good afternoon.
Hey, Tom, good afternoon. How are you doing, man?
You like that, golf guru. You like that?
Yeah, I'm the guru of something. That's all right.
Hunter, looking at the leaderboard,
Phil Mickelson, Henrik Stenson, Soren Yeltsin, Keegan Bradley, last year's winner, Zach Johnson, Bill Haas, a former FedEx Cup winner, Charles Schwartzel, a man who's got a green jacket. Sergio Garcia is tied for sixth. Matt Kuchar's up there. Martin Keimer. They got to be happy with this leaderboard.
Oh, everybody's really happy with it, I think. And I think it's going to turn into a great weekend. If you look even back at the 200 pars, I'm going to go back that far and say they have a shot, too. You got Rory McIlroy back there, somebody with good experience. And I'm going to give you a dark horse back there. Well, you got Dustin Johnson as well, but my dark horse is going to be Patrick Reed. I'm telling you right now, I like Patrick's game. He loves playing links golf in this weather, and I don't know if Phil's body will hold up for four rounds and his concentration.
Shot four over today. Patrick Reed shot three over today, two under for the tournament. Ricky Fowler lurking back there at one under. A guy who I thought would do better. I had Sergio Garcia, me and some friends of mine, we get together and put a little pool together, and I took Sergio Garcia, and a guy who finished up on the leaderboard in the Scottish Open last week, plus 13. I'm a little disappointed with how Danny Lee showed up this week. But J.B. Holmes, good to see him on the leaderboard. Let's talk about the 2 days that were round one and round two. Round one, nice, sunny. The breeze stayed down. It was a little warm. Looked like an American golf course weather-wise, but it is a links course. But when there's no wind blowing and there's no weather, a links course can be had. And Phil Mickelson showed that by just lipping out a putt for 62. I'm a firm believer old Tom Morris was the ghost of old Tom Morris, kept that ball out of the hole. But talk about Mickelson's 62 yesterday as you were watching, 63 yesterday as you were watching that, how he went out in better, came in better than he went out, and coming in is supposed to be the harder of the two.
Yes, well, you know, Phil talked about that yesterday. He likes the back nine at Troon better than the front nine. He thinks it suits his game better, and it showed coming in. Well, yeah, and he also had a perfect day. I mean, a sunny day like that in Scotland is almost unheard of. So for that to happen the way that it did, it was just kind of like the perfect storm for Phil. And I think he's really hoping that this weekend it'll keep raining, the wind will keep blowing so nobody can catch up, you know, because that's what it's going to come down to. These guys back in the pack, to catch him after shooting around like that, they're going to have to make up the scoring somehow. And if he just keeps on trucking and can shoot one or two under each day, I think he's got a shot to win this thing, because it's very hard to chase in weather like that.
It is very hard to chase in weather like that. And here's the what we're talking about. Yesterday, the sun, no wind. Yesterday, they were taking 5 irons and 4 irons off the first tee so that they wouldn't reach the pot bunkers that are there that come into play. This morning, wind changes direction. Wind directly in the player's face on number one as they're sitting there at Royal Troon on the tee box, hitting three woods that are coming 40 yards short of landing in the same place and ended up in the same place, three woods, as the 5 irons and 4 irons yesterday. Really, the wind all in their face on the first nine going out. It really made the golf course a tough situation. And you could tell how they were dressed with the layers and everything. That adds a little something to it as well. Just a complete turnaround from the weather they faced yesterday.
Yes, and if you had morning afternoon draw, you got the worst of it, because this afternoon in Scotland, Jason Day on the 14th hole, the wind was blowing 34 miles an hour into his face, and literally I think he took a 4 iron and came up 30 yards short of the par 3 green.
He is still, though, he finished his round at 70 today, one under on the day. He's plus 2 for the tournament, but well above the cut line. The cut line is projected. Well, it's not projected. It is. The cut line is at plus 5. The players that didn't make the cut, Ernie Els didn't make the cut. Let me see if I can get you anybody. Justin Leonard didn't make the cut. Vijay Singh, David Lingmuth, neither one of them made the cut. Mateo Manassero didn't make the cut. trying to get you some more people that Shane Lowry, a guy who is from that area, did not make the cut. Ross Fisher from England did not make the cut. Brendan Steele didn't make the cut. Hideki Matsuami did not make the cut. You know, there's a large list of people who didn't make the cut, and it's all with Jimmy Walker. He shot plus nine today, an 80, plus nine to go plus 10. Billy Horschel, who was up on the leaderboard today when the day began at four under, plus 14 on his round today, shot an 85. He shot 67-85. 67-85. That's a difference of 18 strokes.
Yeah, poor Billy. He didn't want to talk after the round, Tom, and I texted him. I said, keep your head up, man. And he just texted me back, I don't want to talk about it.
Scott Piercy shoots an 81 today. There was an 84 today, an 83 today. Does Billy have the worst round of the day? I'm looking at the leaderboard. The 85, I think, is going to be the worst round of the day. But there's a lot of high 70s and mid 70s and a bunch of 80s, 81s. Here's the round that you want to talk about. Bubba Watson shoots one under yesterday. Shoots five over today. It's just when you go out in the afternoon, you're at a distinct disadvantage. Jordan Spieth, he was even yesterday, shot four over today. When you went out in the afternoon today, it was just brutal.
Oh, yes. I mean, they were getting pelted in the face, and you could just see that they didn't even want to, you don't want to be out there in it, much less playing golf in it.
It reminds me of that. Remember the 81 Tiger Woods shot in the British Open? I think it was six or eight years ago now. He shot an 81 on day two because the rain was just coming down. It was about 35-40 mile-an-hour winds. It's just – it's a ridiculous climate to play golf in when the weather's like that. And Phil Mickelson has been lucky. He got to go out in the afternoon yesterday when it was relatively calm and sunny, and he was able to take advantage of the golf course. And he got to go out this morning, you know, in the morning rounds when the golf course, while it was cloudy and the wind was a little up, there was not the driving rain. There wasn't the constant 30 mile an hour wind. And so he got to play. Is it safe to say, Hunter, that sometimes you can be really good and just unlucky and it cost you at the British Open? Your draw sometimes can cost you at the British Open?
Absolutely. I think that's what it's going to come down to tomorrow as well. I like the guys, like I said, back at 200 par because they go out earlier. Phil's got to go out tomorrow, and the forecast is 25 to 30 mile an hour gust with 20 mile an hour sustained winds the entire afternoon. So that's why I like the guys that go out earlier, because you don't have to deal with the wind. I mean, I don't care if it rains. They can play in the rain, but this wind is unreal.
Well, that's Scotland in the summertime is what that wind is. I spent in 1992, I went over there with, on a 1991, excuse me, I went over there on an exchange program with the University of Edinburgh. They are an education school, and we exchanged with them from Georgia Southern University, and I spent 9 weeks over there. And you can have a day in July, late July, early August, where one day it's 70 degrees and sunny, and the next day it's 70 degrees, but it's not sunny, and the rain's pelting down on you, and the wind's blowing, and it feels like it's 50.
Absolutely. I can't imagine that.
So you're giving some guys back at two under a shot. That's Patrick Reed, J.B. Holmes at two under, Dustin Johnson in at two under, Roy McIlroy back there. So they go out in the morning, so you're giving them a shot on moving day to really put some pressure on Phil Mickelson.
Absolutely. I think that, you know, Phil is in control, obviously, but, you know, just going out in that weather that he's going to have to face tomorrow, it's going to give these guys a chance to move up the leaderboard, and we'll have a good Saturday and Sunday, hopefully.
And the weather's not looking any better, by the way, on the forecast for Sunday either.
Yeah, well, that's Scotland. There you go.
Hey, Hunter, if people want to find you, where can they find you nowadays? I know you're periodically checking with us and all, but is there a website if they want to read some of your stuff or they want to find out what's rolling, what's going on with Hunter? Where can they find you?
HunterTurnerGolf.com.
Hunter Turner Golf. Did you see? Now you got your own website and everything. I don't know about you. You're big timing us now, I think. I think that's what's going on here.
It all starts with Buddy Martin Media, so, you know, I start right there.
Hey, let me ask you this, Hunter. Are you surprised by all the people that have pulled out of the Rio Olympics, the world golfers that have pulled out of the Rio Olympics? And two, the Olympics committee now says because of how many of the world's top golfers have pulled out, they're going to reevaluate whether golf should be an Olympic sport after this Olympics.
Yes, well, you know, I'm not surprised. I think that golf, they didn't grow up wanting to be Olympians. These other sports that are in the Olympics, you know, if you look back, tennis, when it first came back to the Olympics in, I think it was, what, the 80s, 1982, they, you know, the top players didn't play because they had no aspirations of being an Olympian. Well, it's the same with golf now, coming back after 100 years. If Tiger Woods and Jack Nicklaus would have played in the Olympics, these young guys would be there. But they have no aspirations. And the money's here. You know, the money's here. You don't get paid to be an Olympian. So I think it's going to take time. It's going to take a good Olympics year this year in Rio for them to want to keep it around. And then we'll see if the guys show up in 2020. But, you know, there's all this money, Tom, and these guys go over there, and if something were to happen to derail their career or something, you know, there's just too much money on the line, I think, for most of these guys.
I agree with you. There's way too much money in endorsements and prize purses on the PGA Tour and the European PGA Tour to jeopardize it to go play in something that happens once every 4 years. Hey, Hunter, thanks for checking in with us. Thanks for talking about the British Open with us, and it's hunterturnergolf.com, correct?
You got it.
Hunter Turner, have a good afternoon. Have a good weekend, buddy.
You too, Tom.
Hunter Turner checking in. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll wrap up hour number two, get you set up for Southern Pigskin tonight, right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with their clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz.
Hi, I'm State Farm agent Angie Lewis. Come see me and my team for all your insurance and financial needs in the beautiful downtown historic district, 416 East Fort King Street, or call 291-2444.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. If you have an award or a trophy in your house, there's more than a good chance it came from BJ Trophies Gifts and Awards. At BJ Trophies, Floyd Hirschberger and his staff have a lot more than just trophies. Among the items they specialize in are donor recognition walls and trees, personalized or engraved gifts, cast bronze dedication plaques, wide format digital printing with posters, banners, and signs, and promotional products. Floyd is the official trophy and awards maker for the Voice of Ocala radio show and is North Central Florida's leader in custom recognition programs, corporate awards, industrial engraving, unique gifts, and advertising specialties. When Angie Lewis went shopping for something to award to the winners of her State Farm Good Neighbor Award, she shopped first at BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Check them out at 1735 Northeast Jacksonville Road on North Magnolia's Miracle Mile, or call them today at 352-732-2249. BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Trophies is just our middle name.
Palm Garden is proud to announce the next Chats at the Garden. On Tuesday, July 19th, from 4 to 5 p.m., Rocky Ramirez from Regions Bank will be the guest speaker, and his topic will be identity theft and how to avoid scams to protect your assets. Seating is limited, so RSVP for Tuesday, July 19th, Chats at the Garden, by calling 854-6262. That's 854-6262. Palm Garden is located at the corner of Southwest 27th Avenue and Southwest 34th Street.
common sense isn't that common any longer. But Monday at 9.05 a.m., Don Browning, U.S. Navy veteran, businessman, aviator, race car driver and owner, artist, and land developer will be our guest to discuss some down-to-earth, common-sense things for you to consider. Each week, topics will be relevant to current events, and your participation is encouraged. So listen Monday at 9.05 a.m. and call in with your comments as Don Browning brings common sense your way.
Hey Ocala, this is Kelly Hart, executive editor of Ocala Magazine. Did you know last year Ocala Magazine won more awards in excellence than any other publication in Florida? And this year, Ocala Magazine was named best consumer magazine in the state. Now you can join me every Friday at 10 a.m. on Ocala Magazine Radio, where we bring the pages of Ocala Magazine to life, right here on The Source. Ocala Magazine thanks you for making us number one. And remember, there is only one Ocala Magazine.
Hi, this is Mayor Kent Gwynn. Have you ever wondered what the younger generation thinks? Well, here's the chance to find out. The Mayor and the Millennials coming soon to WOCA 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
WOCA, WOCA.
We are The Source, WOCA.
Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala on a Friday afternoon. It is about 4:52, and the rain has arrived in Ocala. Be prepared to take cover if you need to. I don't see any warnings yet up on the Weather Channel, but I will be checking periodically. Coming up in hour number three, it's Southern Pigskin tonight. It is our SEC Media Day wrap-up show. It plays at 5 o'clock. On the show this week will be Buddy Martin, myself, of course, and Tom James with a roundtable. You'll also hear from Coach Jim McElwain of the Florida Gators. Coach Kirby Smart of the Georgia Bulldogs. He was at SEC Media Days as well. You'll hear from Gerard Davis and Marcus May of the University of Florida. So all that coming up on the 5 o'clock hour, Southern Pigskin tonight. Once again, give you a quick update on the leaderboard at the British Open. Phil Mickelson is your leader. He is in the clubhouse, 2-under today, 10-under for the tournament. Henrik Stenson at 9-under, 6-under on the day, shot a 65 today. Soren Yeltsin is 7-under with a 3-under today. Keegan Bradley also 7-under with a 3-under today. Zach Johnson, your defending champion, a 1-under 70 today for a 5-under total for the tournament. Bill Haas, 1-under today for 4-under for the tournament. So there are your leaders on the leaderboard for the British Open. The lightning is out. It's lightning a little bit. It's raining. The thunder's out. So take care out there on the roads, folks. Be very careful. Hope you have a great weekend. Coming up next, Southern Pigskin tonight, like I said, is going to be a wrap-up of SEC Media Days. Buddy Martin was there at the beginning of the week, and he was able to get some conversation with Mr. College Football Tony Barnhart, along with he asked a few questions of Coach Jim McElwain of the Florida Gators, and got a couple questions in with Gerard Davis and Marcus May of the Florida Gators defense. So that's all looking forward, all something to look forward to on Southern Pigskin Night. Coming up next, I want to thank my guest today, Captain Corey Taylor of the Ocala Police Department. Buddy Martin checked in earlier in this hour, and of course, the ever-famous Hunter Turner. For everybody involved, I'm Tom Schmitz. Coming up next, Southern Pigskin Tonight, right here on WOCA, The Source. Yeah.
This is Kendall Carpenter with Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club. I wanted to introduce you to the finest equestrian opportunity available. If you love horses and enjoy Central Florida's mild climate and rich rolling landscape, come explore Golden Ocala. Bridle trails weave their way through this stunningly beautiful community of stately homes. Our state-of-the-art equestrian center will meet all of your equestrian needs with style. Visit us at goldenocala.com.
Have you been diagnosed with BPH or an enlarged prostate gland? Are you tired of getting up at night to visit the bathroom? You may be eligible for the Equinox study, a clinical research study of an investigational drug to reduce the number of times you wake up to urinate at night, a condition known as nocturia. To qualify, you must be male, be at least 18 years of age, have been diagnosed with BPH, have been bothered by nocturia for at least 1 year, and meet additional study requirements. Qualified participants will receive all study medication and study-related care from a dedicated team of medical staff at no cost. Health insurance is not required to participate. Again, the Equinox study is for males, ages 18 and older, who are diagnosed with BPH and have been bothered by nocturia for at least 1 year. To find out more and to see if you qualify, please call 1-352-234-8436. That's 1-352-234-8436.
Are you in the process of planning your wedding reception? Or are you planning that birthday party for someone special? Or maybe you're just looking to throw a party for yourself? Are you in charge of this year's company outing and looking for something fresh and fun to do? Well, KT Entertainment is your answer to all those questions. We provide music, trivia, and karaoke for everybody's enjoyment. If you would like to get in touch with KT Entertainment and find out about our competitive prices, call us at 352-512-2611. That's 352-512-2611. Or you can find us on the web at kt4fun.com. That's KT, the number 4, fun.com. So remember, whether it's a wedding reception, a party, or a company outing, it's KT Entertainment for all your karaoke, trivia, or musical needs.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offered as not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Hi, I'm Leah Caruso with Strive Rehabilitation, inviting you to join me Thursday at 11 a.m. for Health Matters. Ocala Health and Strive have teamed up to bring you the latest information on good health services available to you right here at home. This vital information will help you make informed decisions about your health. So don't forget to join me here at 11 a.m. Thursday. It's news you can use from Ocala Health, Strive, and your friends here at WOCA.
Hi, I'm Seth with AA Lock, Dock, and Security. Have you ever thought about the locks or security on your house or business? Have you ever wondered why the keys to your new car cost so much? Well, at AA Lock, Dock, and Security, we can help with securing your valuables. We can even replace those expensive transponder keys. We can give you the knowledge that no one else will. Call AA Lock, Dock, and Security at 867-1965. That's 867-1965.
Putting the local back into radio. 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. WOCA News. Variety. Information. Now. Keep your arms and legs on the inside at all times.
The most trusted name in news, Fox News. Every half hour, only on 96.3 FM, 1370 AM, The Source.
WOCA.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
This is Southern Pigskin Tonight with host Buddy Martin on the Southern Pigskin Radio Network.
Hello and welcome to Southern Pigskin Tonight. I'm your host, Buddy Martin, coming to you in the centermost outpost of the Southern Pigskin Radio Network, back in our studios at WOCA in beautiful Ocala after a jaunt to SEC Media Days in Hoover, Alabama, joined as always by Tom Schmitz. No disrespect to those fine gentlemen who endured the marathon of interviews and the onslaught of writers, reporters, TV golden throats, internet jockeys, and radio antagonists, protagonists. But if I never hear another coach this summer talking about or talking around the expectations and projections of the 2016 season, that would be just fine.
There you go, buddy. Bitch, bitch, bitch. You've been waiting since last January to talk football when it was relevant. You just spent several days of a cushy life eating bonbons, drinking Diet Cokes with the Illuminati of the coaching profession in the SEC, and you want sympathy from me?
Oh, man.
Somebody had to stay back here in the dungeon, you know, keeping the candles lit and the gerbils running on the flywheel.
Okay, my bad. I won't complain about the delayed flight that got me home at 2 a.m. or the countless hours of listening to coaches drone on forever, but that's just me taking one for the team.
Talk about taking one for the team. Your pal Paul Feinbaum made the mistake of challenging Nick Saban. And as we say down south, he kind of drew back a nub.
Well, yes, I thought that little skinny guy with the glasses showed some cojones. And I commend him for going right at the question to a powerful coach who seems a little bit in denial about whether he should be playing somebody who acted badly off the field.
Well, we're going to hear a replay of that Feinbaum-Saban exchange a little later in the show.
Yeah, we are.
We're going to hear a bite from you and Coach Steve Spurrier announcing your new book, Head Ball Coach, on the Feinbaum Show earlier in the week.
Yes, and as we'll talk about later in the show, on the Round Table Square Table with Tom James, the most impressive coach I heard while I was in Hoover was a rookie. We'll share the thoughts of Mr. College Football, Tony Barnhart, as well. Let's hear from Kirby Smart.
Yeah, buddy, Gator fans are anxiously awaiting our thoughts about Jim McElwain and his players.
Yes, and they shall have it in the next segment. But first, it's time for us to go up I-95 and hear from our pals at 3 and Out. Kevin Thomas, B.J. Bennett, and Matt Osborne can be heard weekdays at 3 p.m. on ESPN Coastal Georgia. Fellas, I know you got some predictions on the SEC for us today.
Thanks, buddy. Good to be here with you on Southern Pigskin tonight. Glad to be here as we wind down SEC Media Days and giving you our thoughts on the Southeastern Conference, B.J. Bennett, with how we see it playing out. I think we'll probably fall in line with a lot of folks who voted out there in the media today with, I would gonna go on a very small branch and say most people had Alabama in their bracket. Well, or in their yeah, pick, I should say.
It's a tale of two divisions. It really is in the SEC. You, of course, have very tradition-rich programs in the East, but you have programs that have not been at their best in recent years, and meanwhile, there's just a logjam really behind Alabama in the SEC West. But listen, if you want to talk about the West, I think you have a couple of legitimate college football playoff contenders in Alabama, but also LSU. LSU is very, very good, and the offensive line should be strong. The defensive line should be strong. The skill positions, of course, Fournette, but the wide receivers are great. The secondary is awesome. Les Miles has maybe one of his most talented teams ever, as they didn't have their traditional wave of underclassmen go to the NFL. So I do love LSU. I think they are having a close second in the West. But I'm going to go with Alabama, and that may seem strange for a program that just lost its longtime defensive coordinator, lost a senior quarterback, lost the Heisman Trophy winner, and a number of guys on both sides of the line of scrimmage who were drafted early in the most recent NFL draft. But it's Alabama. They rebuild by competing for championships the very next year. And Nick Saban is the standard setter. Kevin, I don't know about you. I love LSU. I almost feel like I'm sliding them some. But Alabama is the gold standard in college football, and because of that, I'm going to go with them in the West. I know we'll get to the East, but are you?
I will say I like that pick, but I'm just because we in the media tend to usually get it wrong. I will say LSU.
Good for you.
Yeah, they're very, very good. It could all it likely come down to that LSU-Alabama game, which is later in the schedule as well. Alabama does have a couple of rough stretches with some new players that have got to get up to speed. And let's be real, just because you wear the Crimson Tide uniform doesn't mean you play like a five-star every play all the time. I mean, it may seem like that, but they do make mistakes. They did give up, 400-plus yards of offense in the national championship game. So let's not make it that a team that wins a lot and wins very consistently never has any problems. They do have some issues coming into the season. They tend to mask them a lot better than other programs, which is why they've been so successful. But you do have some new guys, and they've got some games early in the season. Give me LSU in this one, just because I feel like LSU's got the team to finally be able to do it. And, I mean, you can't just say Alabama and say, well, they're never going to lose a game ever again because it's Alabama.
No,
I think they have some a loss or so in them, and I think LSU might be the team to give it to them this go-around and win there.
I respect that a lot. Over in the East, my gut tells me you and I will agree. It has to be Tennessee's year. It has to be. Georgia's got a first-year coach. Florida's still trying to figure things out offensively. Really, everybody in the SEC East trying to figure things out offensively. Tennessee brings back the division's best quarterback, a 1,000-yard rusher, plenty of experience up front, one of the top pass rushers in the country on the defensive side of the ball, an elite defensive back there, and Cam Sutton to go along with Derek Barnett on that defense. This has to be Tennessee's year. Can they beat Florida? I mean, if they lose to Florida early, as they have seemingly every year for a lifetime, they're going to be in a hole that they don't want to be in. But I will pick Tennessee in the East, and then I think it's Georgia, Florida in some order. I do think Missouri will be a little better, but there's not the depth in the East that there is in the West.
I heard somebody say earlier this week, Tennessee by default. I think that's a good thing because everybody else either has a lot of questions or they don't know who their quarterback is. And those are hard things to be able to throw out their preseason and say, we feel like we're going to win. I do feel like there is a very much a tier system in the East. Once again, I think Tennessee on paper looks to be the best. Florida and Georgia are definitely right there in terms of can contend if they put it together. And then everybody else is duking it out there below those three in some fashion. Maybe there's a team that surprises. We'll have to wait and see. Quick, who do you think is going to be the coach of the year in 10 seconds?
I think if Tennessee makes it to Atlanta, I'll go with Butch Jones.
I will say Butch Jones will get it as well if Tennessee wins the SEC East. That's going to do it for us. Back to you, buddy, here on Southern Pigskin tonight.
Thanks, fellas. Earlier in the week, while I was in Hoover, Tom Schmitz, Tom James, and I did a long-distance roundtable discussion.
It is time for the roundtable. Buddy Martin, Tom James, Tom Schmitz here, the round. Granted, well, Buddy's probably not at the table, Tom.
No, we have Buddy here via satellite.